Good morning, my dear students. Today I am going to giving lecture on analog communications. This is one of the important subject in our electronics and communication engineering. So basically I will try to cover what is the types of modulations, and the first level of modulation is amplitude modulation. Then this is the lecture today I am going to cover for you. So first, before going to the analog communication and modulation topics, first we should know what is communication and what is the analog means. So here, based on the classification, here I think you all know that very well. So in our electronics and communication engineering, our information is always in the form of signal. So information, or you can consider as a data, or you can consider some message, whatever means you can consider that is useful for the communication, that is in the form of the signal. So signal is our basic information for data transmission. So so information or data or message can be treated as a signal. Now, what is the classification of the signal and what is the definition of the signal? I think you know very well, a signal is a physical quantity which varies with one or more independent quantities. So again, I am repeating the definition of the signal. Signal is a physical quantity which varies with one or more independent quantities. So once the definition of signal is clear, that means whatever the independent quantities, what are the independent quantities which define for the physical quantity of the signal is, it may be amplitude, or it may be time, or it may be frequency, it may be angle, etc. So these are the quantities we can always consider to represent the to define the signal. So these are called as a physical quantities of the signal. Then after that, what are the classifications of the signals? So here I'm going to the classify the signals. The signals are classified into the basic classification are two types. We can consider as the analog, or we can treat this one as a continuous. And the second one is digital or discrete. We can call these are synonyms of the particular signal indications. Analog or continuous, digital or discrete. So this is analog or continuous in terms of what terminology we can classify the classifications of the signal. So here, if I take the signal, can be defined in physical quantity of amplitude and time. This is the, that is the basic definition of the signal. So x-axis I can indicate as a time, and y-axis I can indicate as a amplitude. Here, these two quantities I am using to define my signal. So the classification also, I am taking the these two parameters are amplitude and time to classify the signals. If here the term itself indicates it's a continuous, that means the amplitude and time both are continuous, then the signal is called as a analog signal or continuous signal. And if the term analog, amplitude and time both are discrete, then that signal is called as a discrete signals. In meanwhile, we have one more signal is called as a discrete time signal. This is the another classification we can call here. So this is the most probably we can consider as a in between. It lies in between the analog signal and as well as the digital signal. In again, I'm repeating the point. Here, I'm taking the classification of signal based on the two physical quantities, that is amplitude and time, which is used to define the signal. If the both amplitude and time are continuous, then that signal is called as a continuous signal or analog signal. If the amplitude and time both are discrete, then that signal is called as a discrete signal. If any one of these parameters out of these two, amplitude and time, only time is discrete, then that signal is called as a discrete time signal. That means which is constant, which is still in continuous, that is amplitude is still in continuous mode. But basically always the communication or types of signals, as an engineering students we can classify either analog or digital. The discrete in terms of representation we can call synonymous as a digital terminology. Now this is the classification of signal. Now I am trying to give the pictorial representation of each classification of signal. The first one, analog and continuous. Here I am taking one of the example of sinusoidal signals. Here the amplitude is continuous in every instant of time. We can able to define the amplitude of the signal in every instant of time. That is, there is no break in time as well as amplitude. Then that signal is called as a continuous signal or analog signal. Then I am directly moving to the discrete time signal. Before knowing the discrete time discrete signal, we should know what the discrete time signal. So the basic one of the important so called as a technique used to convert continuous signal into discrete time signal is called as a sampling. The sample means we are just making the signal into samples. I think you know very well how we are doing the perfect example for this bread slices. We have the set of bread, we are making into slices like that. The sampling also doing that. Here it is making the signal into slice, slice, slice. How we are making these slices depends upon the particular time. We are using the uniform time sampling. Mostly we have non-uniform also, that not comes here. I think in the next level of we can discuss about the non-uniform sampling levels also. But here I am just discussing about the sampling. We are doing with uniform intervals of time. Then the signal will be sampled and it looks like this. This is called discrete time. Time is here, amplitude is here. Because how I can say it is a discrete means, here we have the amplitude at t equal to 0, t equal to 1, t equal to 2, t equal like some discrete levels of values only. We cannot tell what is the t 0.1, 0.001, what is the amplitude at 0.003 like that. So that means the time is discrete but amplitude is still in continuous. The next, this is the second stage of the classification, that is discrete time signal. Next, I am going to the next technique used to make the signal as a complete discrete signal is called quantization. So here, what we are doing this, we are doing the quantization here, the time is discrete. Still, we have the amplitude is continuous. We want to make the amplitude also discrete. First, here we are doing in the vertical. Now I am going with the slicing in the horizontal way. Okay, then in this level, I'm just giving some amplitude levels of scales. Like consider this is the A1, this is A2, this is minus A1, minus A2, minus A3 like this. So the nearest possible scale of this level touches which scale, that value I'm indicating in the quantization after the quantization process here. At the t equal to 1 instant, the amplitude touching the A1 point. So I can write it is a A1. Then at t equal to 2, the amplitude is almost touching the A2. I can write it as a A2. This is the value of amplitudes. Then it is almost crossing A1 but near to A1, I can write A1. So like this, this will continue. Here the amplitude is discrete and time also discrete. Then that signal is called as a discrete time signal. Okay. So then the last step is called as a, make it as a complete digital, is called encoding. It is called as encoding. I am making this representation of A1, A2, A1, A1, these levels. After doing the some encoding process, the data will come in the form of ones, zeros, one, zero, like this. This is called as a complete digital data. So now I started with the continuous signals. Here continuous means both amplitude and time is continuous. Then I want to go to the next classification, that is a discrete time by using of sampling process. Here the sampling, I am just doing the making of samples of the data with uniform intervals of time. Then I am getting the discrete time signals. Again, here the time is discrete but amplitude is still continuous. Then I am going to the quantization technique. Here for quantization process, I am using the horizontal slicing with the respective amplitude values. The sample is adjusted to the nearest amplitude values, that is A1, A2, A1 like this. This is called discrete time signals. Then the last step is called encoding to make the complete discrete time signal into the digital signal. So how we are getting this one is, in encoding level, we are using the amplitude values. I am keeping one threshold T. So if the above the threshold, I can keep 1. Below the threshold, I can keep 0. Likewise, I am converting the discrete data into digital data. So this ends the classification of the signal. I think now I covered what the definition of signal and what is the classification of signal. In that classification, what is it, continuous or analog, and what the discrete time, and what the digital and discrete. This is the basic data we need for to justify the our title is analog communication. So now I am taking the next step is called communication.